Come in. Hi, welcome to Codemasters. I'm Rich Eddy, I'm one of the directors here. You join us on a blisteringly cold January lunchtime, actually. This is the main building. This is where we all are based. This is the UK headquarters for the operation. It actually started on a small farm building just over there when David and Richard Darling formed Codemasters in 1986. They were two really successful developers of their time, and they invested their monies they'd earned in creating Codemasters as their own publisher, so they could create their games, work with their friends who were creating games, and control their own publishing operation. It expanded out of there, it grew a bit bigger, and as we went through the generations, as 8-bit became 16-bit, the whole building and operation expanded. Today, we're about 500 to 600 people, depending on our scale of operation at the time, here on site. And then we also have our studio over in Birmingham, which is about 80 miles away, and that's where Formula One games are developed. And then we also have an art facility way out in Malaysia, where a lot of our artists and modelers are based. Come on inside, I'll take you for a bit of a tour.
Come in.
This is our reception. This is where everyone first arrives when they start at Codemasters. So we've got all our hero graphics around the place. Bits from Dirt, the logos, F1, and all our display materials. And the most recent game we released always takes over the floor space. So most recently, our winter hit, Formula One 2011. Further on. Except I don't have my dual card. So this is your actual BAFTA. We're lucky enough to have won two of these. They're really heavy, but this one was for Race Driver Grid, which won the sports category back in 2008. We most recently won another one in 2011 for F1 2010. That BAFTA sat over in our Birmingham office where it's celebrated by everyone over there. We picked up a few gongs over the years. These are some of our favourites, including some PlayStation Awards. There's one actually from Her Majesty the Queen for the Queen's Award of Excellence. That's the bowl down there, which we haven't filled with fruit. And there's stuff recognising Codemasters founders, Richard and David Darling at the top, where they got entered in the Elspeth Hall of Fame. There's various other ones we're particularly proud of, like Race Driver winning Xbox Awards. So these are kind of cherished memories for us all here. Okay, for a bit of a trip down memory lane, as you come into the building, we've got some of our old stuff up on the walls. Most recently, it's not going too far back, but Dirt 2, Flashpoint, Dragon Rising. But there's some old gold discs from when we had some chart hits for Tocker Race Driver, PlayStation 2, V8 Supercars, which was Tocker as it was in Australia, DTM as it was in Germany. Huge sellers in their day. What else have we got? Something we have been known for a while back, the cricket series. This was Brian Lara Cricket, when its first appearance on PlayStation after it progressed from its Sega Mega Drive days. If you really, really love gaming on PlayStation and Mega Drive, you can't help to remember Micro Machines, one of the best multiplayer experiences ever. And kind of more where it kind of all began, certainly on consoles with Tocker Touring, the original one. Actually, no, that's Tocker 2. And way back 1998, I think, Colin McRae Rally, the first one on PlayStation, a real defining moment for Codies, and, you know, something that's given birth to a whole series of games. Well, there's change that's evolved that became the Dirt series, and now we're evolving that as well as we sort of do our extension of the action sports racing, Dirt Showdown. That doesn't mean the Dirt Series is going to lose its rally roots. That will continue. There will still be pure rally dirt games coming too. this is a really old bit of Codemasters that hardly anyone gets to see anymore. This glass greenhouse thing was the original reception. I can tell you how old it was, because just over here, framed for posterity, is the original artwork from BMX Simulator, which was the first Codemasters game published in 86 for Commodore and Spectrum, I believe. So here we are inside of the QA building. It was once upon a time the entire racing studio. It's now a dedicated building, especially for QA. Every game we produce goes through an intense QA procedure. This is where armies of guys try and break the game, test it, do all kinds of strange things to it to make sure it holds up. The process is long and it's really intense. We'll start QAing a game pretty much as soon as it goes into its pre-alpha stages. As soon as it's something playable, we'll start testing it, and that process goes right on, right until master. Okay, so I've shown you around some of the old bits of Codemasters, but what I want to take you through now is to one really modern development studios. This way, to Codemasters Studios, there's still some memory lane stuff here. This is some of the original grid artwork. Loads of people ask us where Grid 2 is, when that's coming back. Well, stay tuned, you might not have to wait too long to hear more about that. But here we go, this is Codemasters Studios. This is sort of where the new building begins, and we've got the great new facilities for all our coders here on site. I'll take you into some of those now. This is one of the main art studios here we have on campus HQ. Fresh out of F1, the guys are now focusing on creating car models and textures and liveries for the dirt showground vehicles. If you look at the screens here, you can see some of them actually being designed and tested to see how they look actually within the game engine. And spin around here, and here's a lighter car model being built in progress. You can see the detail these guys go into. It's pretty much every bit of a car model and put in the game, because you want to smash these babies up, and that's what it's going to fall apart. We'll take a look into how the studios are set up in a sec. This is a kind of floor plan of how we group people together. So you get the main game, design people, stick them in the network people, close to the audio people. So you get a really cohesive feel of what they're building, and they can swap ideas, you know, jump in with ideas about other people's areas as well. That's what brings Codemasters game together, is this really close cohesion of a dev team here on site all working together. There's also a lot of skill sharing as well, not only for work stuff, but people share their skills in after work sessions as well. You can join up for a life drawing class if you want to here, or you can do yoga. We've got some qualified yoga instructors that make relaxing after a hard day at the code very worthwhile. With enough electrical equipment to overheat the building three times over, this is just one half of one studio. This is a dirt showdown, start of it being coded here. The rest of it, and we have a little cool chill out areas for people to test their own game as they're going on to check out other people's games. So you've got a swing across, and there's a whole other section of it. It's executive producer, Clive Moody.
Hello.
And more. So the idea is you keep everyone very tight together, working as a team, very close desk relationship, and you have a really good environment. In the two studios, there's a door that today we really can't go in. This is Inception. This is our ideas factory. In there we have a whole team of people looking at ideas for technology, game design, all kinds of stuff that's going to take us through the next 5-10 years. another little secret place. Very special, this one. This is the prize cupboard. This is where we keep all our community giveaway stuff and promotional bits and pieces. We've got everything in here from giant Cody's beanbags to gifts we've been given. And yeah, to go up, this is a present to us from Stuart Broad, the cricketer who we worked with when we were doing cricket the other year. Aside from the development side of Cody's, there's also the publishing side here, and that sort of all happens up here on the top floor. Sales, marketing, publishing operations. One of our favourite bits is our chill-out area, where we get to play pretty much everything that comes through the studios and other places. So the guys here, that's where the packaging gets designed. We work on logos, putting the designs together, working with Microsoft and Sony to make sure all the packs fit the range and stuff like that. And then up here, there's a few guys that you may have interacted with before. In our community team, there's Samantha Russell, who heads up the community team. You'll know her as @theteencm. Claire, whose Twitter is
Faye.
Faye. F
E Y. F A Y.
Oh, all right. Bevan, you can reach on Twitter at. And Ian, Motor.
Helios
CM. So Ian, you've probably known from working on Dirt and F1. So Codemasters is a fair way out of town, and there's something that every developer needs after a hard day's coding, and that's a bite and a pint. So we built a pub here on site. Part of the Codemasters offices has its own bar called the Master's Arms, so you can come relax before getting back to some work.